My name is Chelsea Tipton II, and I'm the music director of the Symphony of Southeast Texas. It is my pleasure to come to you through the magic of technology, which my friends of the Symphony of Southeast Texas could perform many of these pieces for you, as live performances are always more exciting than listening to recordings. But today, we'll have to work with recordings and a little background I can provide. In addition to my introductions that I would do from the stage, we're also including the teacher's guide your teachers would have received and prepared you to hear this music. We all know that we'll be able to get back to school and to concerts soon. So in the meantime, I hope you enjoy this video and some great, great music. What is jazz? Well, jazz really started with Scott Joplin, who was an African-American composer and pianist born along the border of Texas and Arkansas and raised in Texarkana. Joplin grew up in Arkansas in a musical family. His father played violin and his mother sang and played banjo. This sparked Joplin's wild ambition to pursue music. Joplin taught piano lessons to people who would become well-known musicians and composed the first ragtime piece, Maple Leaf Rag. Ragtime would influence future genres of American music like stride, jazz, and the big band swing. Take a listen to Maple Leaf Rag and how this music laid the foundation for what we call jazz today. George Gershwin was an American composer and pianist born in New York City. He began his career composing and creating Broadway theater works. He went to Paris intending to study with the acclaimed teacher of composition, Nadia Boulanger, but she refused to take him as a student. After he visited Paris, he wrote An American in Paris. He moved back to New York and wrote the opera Porgy and Bess with the help of other composers. Summertime is an aria composed in 1934 for the opera Porgy and Bess, based on the novel Porgy. Du Bois Hayward, the author of the novel, wrote the lyrics for the opera. The song soon became a popular and much-recorded jazz standard. Many critics consider it one of the most beautiful songs Gershwin ever wrote. Let us take a listen to Summertime from the opera Porgy and Bess by George and Ira Gershwin. Louis Armstrong, also known as Satchmo, was an American trumpeter who was famous for his influence on jazz. He was also called Satchmo because his mouth was as big as a satchel or a book bag. Playing trumpet had stretched his cheeks out larger than usual. He grew up in New Orleans, Louisiana, an important city for jazz music. Armstrong also earned fame as a composer, vocalist, and actor. His celebrity status lasted throughout different time periods in the history of jazz, from the 1920s until the 1960s. Armstrong also flourished in styles of music such as Dixieland, swing, and traditional pop. During the swing period, many solo performers became musical stars that everyone knew. Louis Armstrong was one of the many musicians who organized jazz bands and both conducted and played solos with other groups. Others performed on their own or as guests with various bands or orchestras. Members of a big band or other groups became very prominent soloists in their own right. We're going to listen now to one of Satchmo's most famous selections that he recorded. In his recording, Hello Dolly, you will hear Louis Armstrong not only play his trumpet, but he was also a fantastic singer. Let us take a listen. ¶¶
this is Lewis. Darling, it's so nice to have you back where you belong. You looking swell, darling. I can tell, darling. You still growing, you still going strong. I feel the room swaying, for the band's playing one of our old favorite songs from way back when. So take a rap, fellas, find an empty lap, fellas. Darling, never go away again.
Duke Ellington, known as the Duke, was born in Washington, D.C., and died at the age of 75 in 1974 in New York City. Ellington was a famous jazz composer and pianist who wrote many tunes that would become jazz standards, played by nearly every big-name band in the jazz world. He was widely known for his influences and effects on jazz, but he considered himself an artist of American music rather than just jazz. Big bands developed in the 1930s from the jazz styles of earlier years. Dance bands played in hotel ballrooms, dance halls, and it became larger and larger. Of all things, radio encouraged the growth of big bands. Duke Ellington wrote, "It don't mean a thing if it ain't got that swing," in 1931. He used the term swing in the song as just another term for rhythm. He did not know that in about 3 years, the swing style of music would come into the world. Take a listen to Duke Ellington's "It Don't Mean a Thing If It Ain't Got That Swing."
Don't mean a thing if you ain't got that swing.
It don't mean a thing, all you gotta do is swing.
Makes no difference if it's sweet or hot. Just give that rhythm every little thing you've got.
It don't mean a thing if you ain't got that swing.
Da 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 da
Thank you for taking a few moments of your day and welcoming the Symphony of Southeast Texas to your musical education. We hope that you learned a little bit more about jazz and how it started here in America. Names like Scott Joplin, Duke Ellington, and George Gershwin take an essential place in musical history. It has been our pleasure to help you get to know these great composers and performers. We hope that shortly we can see one another at live concerts, and we look forward to performing for you. In the meantime, take a look at our symphony website, www.sost.org, to learn more about our musicians and concerts.